Hello! We've already talked about disc harrows on this channel multiple times. Today, however, we will focus on a few technical aspects on their selection. Three matters are crucial: disc diameter, disc tilt angle, as well as the distance between the discs. In today's episode, we'll explain what should you pay attention to during the selection of the disc harrow. Let's start with the diameter of the harrow disc. This is a key factor affecting its effectiveness in the field. The size of the disc is important during the work in the field. The larger the diameter, the deeper the harrow can penetrate into the soil. Larger discs reach deeper, which allows for better soil transformation. However, they may require more power from the tractor because they have to overcome more resistance during work in the field. Large discs are better at shredding soil and crop residues, while smaller ones may be more suitable for shallower surface cultivation. The diameter of the disc also affects the speed of work. Under certain conditions, for example when working in a plowed field, smaller discs may allow for faster progress of work. Additionally, smaller discs are usually more prone to clogging in the event of a large amount of plant residues in the field. Smaller discs are better for delicate tillage work or in the areas where we want to keep more post-harvest residues on the surface of the ground. On the other hand, larger discs are more suitable for soil cultivation and more effective in mixing plant residues with soil, for example after harvesting corn. Another issue is the distance between the discs. Disc harrows are mainly used for crushing lumps of soil, stripping the stubble, mixing plant residues with the ground, and preparing the field for sowing or planting. On heavier and more cohesive soils, discs placed closer together can better crush the lumps of soil. However, on lighter soils, a greater distance between the discs might be more effective. If the purpose of the harrow is to move the soil deeper, discs placed further apart will be more effective. However, for shallow cultivation or crushing topsoil, a smaller distance between the discs will be better. In the presence of a large amount of residues, discs placed further apart help to mix them better with the soil. Particularly large crop residues need more space, so as not to cause clogging. The tractor power also matters. The closer the discs are to one another, the less tractor power is needed. Larger spacing of working elements means heavier machine and higher requirements for tractor. The working height of the harrow is another aspect which might affect the penetration of the disc into the soil and thus on work efficiency. The technical condition of the harrow should also be taken into account. Wearing discs change the distance between one another and affect the result of work. It is also worth paying attention to the coupling for accompanying machines. Disc harrows with smaller disc spacing can be combined with seeders, creating a seedbed set. The last aspect is the tilt angle of the disc. It determines at what angle the discs are positioned in relation to the direction of movement and the surface of the soil. It has an impact on the effectiveness of the harrow and the quality of work in the field. The greater the angle of inclination of the disc, the more intensive work in the soil. Discs that are set at a greater angle will work more aggressively, penetrating the ground and overturning it. Higher disc angle can control and hide weeds better, which is important in plant care. The angle of inclination might affect the ability of the harrow to grind and mix plant residues with the soil, which may be important to prepare the field for successive cultivation activities. It also has an impact on how deeply the disc penetrates the ground. A larger angle usually means shallower operation, which might be beneficial under certain cultivating conditions. However, when there is a lot of plant residues on the surface, higher disc inclination angle can increase the risk of clogging of the harrow. A larger tilt angle can also lead to faster wear of disc, especially in difficult soil conditions. Machines with discs set at a sharper angle are usually more suitable for post-harvest work, while those with a moderate angle can be used both for work before as well as after harvest. We hope that having watched this video, you already know what issues to pay attention to during the selection of the disc harrow. If you need any further information, then please visit our website rolmako.com. You will find an article there dedicated just to this topic. The link can be found in the description. We also invite you to contact us directly. Our specialists will try to dispel any doubts and help you choose the right implement. We would like to thank you for your attention and invite you to the next film.